Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to talk about why do I have 9 credit cards with a total limit of $119,000. And first, I kind of need to give you my backstory a little bit. And I am from a typical middle-class family, and growing up, I wasn't really taught a lot about finance from my parents, and I didn't certainly get any in high school or college. But when I was 18, I knew that I was supposed to get my first credit card. And the reason why you're told is because you need to start building your credit history. However, I was told that credit cards are dangerous, credit cards are something to be kind of wary of, and I always felt uncomfortable having my credit card on me or using my credit card. And what we're going to talk about today is something I refer to as the cash tax. And essentially, when you pay with cash or a debit card for anything, you're agreeing to pay 2 to 6% more than you would have if you had just used a credit card to pay for it. And I'll give you an example. Let's say you go to the grocery store and your total is $50. The clerk says, your total is going to be $50. Please give me your credit card. And you respond, I don't have a credit card. I would like to pay with cash. And the clerk now says, no problem, your total is now $52.50. To which you would reply, what? That is total BS. Why did you raise the price? But when you look at the math, this is essentially equivalent. Not using a credit card and getting 2 to 6% cash back on purchases or payments is the equivalent to agreeing to pay 2 to 6% more for everything that you buy or pay for. And no one explains this to you, but this is essentially how our entire financial system is built. When a store opens and they agree to be able to have credit card sales with either Visa, MasterCard, or American Express, they're essentially paying those vendors, or anyone is paying Visa, American Express, or MasterCard, usually 1 to 5%, for each purchase that you make with their card. Now, this increases the costs for the vendors, the stores, the businesses, whatever, and they pass that cost on to you. So by not participating in this system, you're just agreeing to pay more for literally everything you buy. And so we've invented this financial system in America where you have to walk this tightrope over a pit of fire and debt and horrible pain, because it is so tempting to spend money you don't have. To give someone a credit card with a $2,000, $3,000, $10,000 limit and tell them, treat it like a debit card, treat it like cash, don't spend more than you have, for a lot of people, this is difficult, this is hard. Which is why you'll get a lot of exposure to financial experts like Dave Ramsey. He's probably the most famous, where he tells you, don't play their game. Cut up your credit cards. All debt is bad. All debt is evil. Don't do it. And this is the way to go. If you are someone who can't make a budget, can't spend less than you earn, or you know, you're not good with numbers and you lose track of stuff, Dave Ramsey takes it to the extreme where he says, you know, ignore your credit score, don't have credit cards, live cash only. But by going the Dave Ramsey way, you're essentially agreeing to pay 2 to 6% more for everything that you buy. Which is why earlier this year, I got exposed to these guys. I'm a follower of Graham Stevens' YouTube channel, and he introduced me to two other useful channels, Credit Shifu and Ask Sebi. These guys have exposed me to credit cards, and we're going to talk about two things today. Credit card optimization and a little bit about credit card churning. The first one is the one I really want to focus on with you today in this video. But first we have to talk about the rules of credit cards. I made a video about how your FICO credit score is calculated. Check that out if you want to know specifically the breakdowns. But the number one rule you have to follow is to never cancel your oldest credit cards. The reason why is because the length of your credit history is really important when determining your FICO score. And when you cancel old accounts, it shortens the length of those credit lines, and then it hurts your score. So if you have old credit cards, as long as they don't cost you anything, there's no annual fees, don't cancel them. Number two is avoid cards with annual fees. There might be some good exceptions to this. You kind of have to do the math on whether or not the annual fee is worth it. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a second. Number three, these are really obvious ones now. Don't ever miss a payment. It hurts your credit score. It'll jack up your APR. You'll get a late penalty. Number four, this one is difficult for people to do, but never carry over a balance. Pay off your credit cards in full every month and just buy less stuff. You know, live within your means, make a budget, be disciplined, eat at home, live with less, find a way to simplify it. Credit cards are fantastic if you never carry over balance, and that goes into number five, you never pay interest. Credit cards don't cost you anything as long as you aren't paying any interest to the credit card companies. Number six, we don't really care about APR. If you never carry over a balance, doesn't matter if the APR is 12%, 18%, 39%, you're never gonna pay them any money, so it doesn't matter. And seven and eight, I do not play the balance transfer game or the cash advance game. A lot of people think they're gaming the credit card companies by saying, oh, this card has no balance transfers, 0% APR for 15 months. I'm just gonna rack up $8,000 worth of debt and then ignore it for a year. Credit card companies know people do this. They know that you're gonna get stuck with that debt and you're not gonna be able to pay it off, and they're gonna make money off you eventually. So once again, don't carry over balances. Don't mess around with balance transfers or cash advances. Just zero them out every month. Now, these are the nine cards I have. The first six have no annual fee. The next three do have an annual fee, and I'm gonna have to explain to you why I don't pay them. So for me personally, I don't have any annual fees for any of these cards. We're gonna go through these. The first one is the USAA Rewards Visa, and for me, this card is worthless. This is my oldest credit card, which means I can't cancel this card. I did have a card before this one that had like 10 years of history, and I didn't understand how credit scores work, and I actually canceled that card. And that was a huge mistake. So this one now is my oldest. It's only 3 years old. But I'm basically going to spend $20 on this card once every 6 months just to keep the account active. But as far as the cashback rewards, this card offers me nothing of use. So there's no reason day-to-day to ever use it. The next card is the Military Star Card, and this is a credit card for the military because I'm active duty. And this card has 10% off food court purchases on base. So I literally only have it when I want to go to Burger King or Popeye's Chicken on base, which is like two or three times a month. And for any other reason, there is no reason to use this card. In the upper right, I'm putting my APRs and my credit limits. If you're curious about those kind of things, go ahead and check it out. But I'm, for each one of these cards, just telling you what I use this card for and why I have it. The next card is fantastic. If you can bank with USAA because either you're military, a veteran, or family member of one of those first two, then I highly recommend this card, because this gives you 5% cash back on all gas. This is any gas station, not just gas stations on base. You also get 5% off base exchange purchases, which is very nice at like the gas station or the BX on base. So I use it for gas and BX purchases. The next card is the Uber Visa card. If you didn't know, Uber has its own credit card. And this one gives you 4% off on dining. So if I go to Papa John's or if I go to Jimmy John's, I'll take this card with me to make the purchase, and it gives you 4% cash back. I also wanna say about this card, if you spend $500 within 3 months, you get 100 back. That is basically 20% off your first $500 worth of purchases, which is a great reward. So definitely do that if you can. The next card is the Chase Amazon Prime card, and I think a lot of people know about this card. It doesn't have an annual fee, but you have to be an Amazon Prime member to get it. Prime membership is $119 a year, but if you use it a lot for free shipping or because you like the services that comes with Amazon Prime, then there's no reason to not have this card, because this gives you 5% off all Amazon purchases. So go ahead and on your Amazon accounts, load this card, use it as your default purchases for anything on Amazon. 5% cash back is an amazing benefit. The next card is kind of the catch-all. This is the Citi Double Cash card. This card is pretty popular because it offers 2% off everything. And all the previous cards have varying cashback rates for different categories, but usually there's the catch-all 1% default for everything else. The Citi is 2% for everything across the board. And 2% cashback, when you can use this card for your phone bill, your electricity bill, any kind of subscriptions that you have, getting 2% off everything is great as a catch-all. So this is kind of like the fallback card when nothing you want to spend money on falls in any other category. The next card is the Blue Cash Preferred American Express. This card does have an annual fee of $95 a year, but you get 6% off on supermarkets and 6% off on streaming services. So if you have an HBO, Hulu, Netflix subscription, you can get 6% off your subscription rate. As well as 6% off supermarkets, I can't find better than that for any other card. So I feel like the $95 annual fee is worth it. First, there's a $250 bonus if you spend $1,000 within 3 months. Shouldn't be pretty hard to do if you're doing all your grocery shopping with this card. Now, how much do you need to spend in a year to make up for that $95? And the answer is $1,583, as I put there. If you spend, you know, $400 a month on groceries, that's over $4,000 a year on food. And this card pays for itself for that first $1,583, and then you're earning 6% off everything after that. It's pretty good. Now, I don't pay the annual fee for the Blue Cash Preferred because of something called the Civil Members Civil Relief Act and the Military Lending Act. Because of this, credit cards with Chase, Citi, or American Express don't charge active duty military members the annual fees. I did a video about the Delta Sky Miles American Express card and how much I made off of the sign-up bonus for that card. I don't really want to talk about credit card churning in this video. We're going to talk about that in the next video. But know that I'm signing up for these additional luxury cards, these premier cards that have like $400, $500, $600 annual fees for the sign-up bonuses. If you can spend, for example, for the Sky Miles card, $5,000 within 3 months, you earn $7,500 Delta Sky Miles. That's easily worth over $1,000 in airfare. In addition to, this card has many other perks that, as an active duty military member, I get for free. Same goes with the Chase Sapphire Reserve. I just got this card. This is my most recent one. I haven't even started putting money on it, but if I can spend $4,000 within 3 months, I can earn 50,000 CSR points, which is good for hotel and airfare. Now, you might be asking, how do I spend this much money? And I'll explain it more in detail on my next video, but short answer, I can pay my rent with a credit card. And if I just pay in advance, it kind of outpaces the fee I get assessed for paying with a credit card. So it's a really good deal. Real quick, these three cards, I just ignore them. I'm not going to use these for day-to-day purchases. These three cards are not part of my credit card optimization strategy. So that leaves these six. And once again, I only use the American Express Cash Preferred for supermarkets and streaming, cashback rewards for gas and BX purchases, the Prime card for Amazon, the Uber card for dining, the Star card for food courts, and then the Citi Double Cash for everything else. If you've made it this far in the video, you must be asking yourself, Jake, why are you doing this? How can this possibly be worth your time? To which, let's put in the numbers. If you want to pause the video, you can see how much I think I spend for each of those categories per week or per month, and then how much I'm saving by using credit cards and then paying them off every month. The total value I estimate is easily over $500. The numbers I put in are $570. For you, it could easily be higher. And I'm not crazy. I'm not putting all these cards in my wallet and walking around with them. So the first three are in a drawer safe at home. I don't really use them or touch them. The Uber card, the Citi card, and the Prime card are in my desk, and I don't use those day to day, so I only take them out when I need to use them. So what's actually in my wallet, and it's the Star card for food court purchases, the USAA card for gas purchases, and then the Blue Cash Preferred for grocery shopping. And that's all I have. I think having three cards in my wallet isn't too much, or isn't too much of a burden. I want to end this video by saying that I'm going to be getting more credit cards. I'm going to go well past 9. If any card offers me a better cashback reward for a certain category, I am going to get that card to just optimize it. In addition, I have been enjoying, chasing sign-up bonuses for some of these premier cards. I'm going to talk more about that in my next video, but I'm enjoying that too. Don't see any reason not to do it. So yeah, if this is something that interests you, I highly consider getting into it. It definitely, an extra $500 a year, you can put that in investments, you can save that, or you can have a great weekend, take a trip with it. Okay guys, if you enjoyed this video or thought it was useful, please give it a thumbs up so other people can find it. In addition, leave a comment down below if you know of a card that has a better cashback reward for a category, or if potentially I'm missing something altogether here. In addition, subscribe to my channel. I post weekly about military and finance topics, and I will be making more videos soon, so check those out. Until next time, take care.